Okay, so welcome and thank you for signing up for the Physics Society Basic LaTeX workshop. Yeah, so for today we'll be using the Jupyter notebook to learn the basics of Python, which includes like how to create variables, how to store things in your computer. What are some of the Python data types? How to create loops, how to create control statements, and how to use this in Python, followed by how to import some packages in Python. This might seem a bit foreign to you for now, but after I go through the workshop, hopefully it will start to sound familiar to you. Okay, so I hope you guys have followed the instructions in the email and installed Anancoda yesterday. Yeah. So first thing first, you need to open Anancoda, Anancoda Navigator. So for those on Windows, you can open up the start menu and then search for Anancoda. Then the first thing that pop out should be the Navigator. So when you open that, it will take some time to load. And when you're done, and when it's done, you should see this in front of you. So like today we'll be using JupyterLab. So you just click launch on JupyterLab, and then what you should see is this in front of you. If my screen, the font size is too small, right? You can unmute yourself and tell me. And if I'm going too slow, just unmute and tell me so that I will know to slow down. Yeah, if you type in the chat, I might miss it. So yeah, it'll be better if you can unmute yourself. Yeah, okay, let me change my screen for a while. Okay, yeah, so when you launch JupyterLab, like this, you should see this in front of you. So over here on the left, you can see that there's some file manager. So for this file manager, right, the file that's currently open, I need to share another screen. Yeah. The file manager is showing this particular file. So what you can do is come to the C drive under your users, then under the user that you're using. Yeah, then if you come here, this is the file manager in JupyterLab is showing. So what I want you to do now is to unzip the file that I sent you in the email or that I sent in the chat earlier. Unzip that file and then like copy and then create a folder and then put everything in that folder in this location over here. So for me, I put it as basic Python workshop 2122. Yeah. So inside there we have all the things that you need for the workshop today. Okay, so back to JupyterLab. When you have unzipped everything and you have placed all your content in this location, what you can do now is to go to that folder. Let's find that folder first. Okay, so over here, then double click on the basic Python workshop notebook. Yeah, so what you have opened in front of you is the notebook file format. So when you code in Python, right? There are two ways that you can do it. You can either use a notebook like this, or you can use the Python file itself. I will show you an example of the Python file later, but for today we'll be using the notebook because I think it is more user-friendly, and then you don't have to rerun the entire code you don't have to run the entire code if you only want to run certain parts of your code. Yeah. So for the notebook, we have cells. Like for example, this is one code cell. This is another code cell. Yeah. So all your codes are in cells. And then you see all these text here. This is also, if you double click on it, this is also a cell. But this cell, instead of a code cell, it is a markdown cell. So this markdown cell is just used for you to like type notes, I guess. Yeah. Type something like notes. Yeah, so the language or the formatting that is used for these cells is called Markdown. Yeah. So in this format, so in this formatting style, you can do things like this if you want to do header and so on. But then but this won't be the focus of today's workshop. Yeah. So for the cell, right, you want, so let's say any cell, for example, this code cell or this markdown cell, right, you can run it by clicking this run, this play button here. Or alternatively, if you want to use your keyboard, you can just click Shift Enter. And then let's say you want to create a new cell above this cell, what you can do is just click this you want to create a new cell, you can click the plus here, and then it will insert a cell below. But let's say you want to insert a cell on top, what you can do is to press A, and then it will create one on top. Or if you want to create one below, you can just press B, and it will create a cell below. And let's say you want to delete a cell, what you can do is to just right click and then delete cell. Or another way you can do is to double click D. So yeah, I press D twice, I delete one cell. I press D twice again, I delete another cell. Yeah, be careful about this, because when you delete a cell, you cannot control Z and undo the delete. So unless you are really sure which cell you are selecting, I suggest that you actually right click and delete the cell instead of pressing double D to delete the cell. Okay, so that is a short introduction to the notebook format.